Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to talk about how to pass the department number of this interactive report to another interactive report. Because in this page I have two reports and every report corresponds to one table, and the two tables connected by the department number is a foreign key. And let me show you. When I click the one row of this interactive report, I will pass the department number to this report, and this report will refresh accordingly. And when I click the another row, and I get another department number, and the report will refresh. How to achieve it? Let's go to the page designer. In the left plan, we have two regions: department regions and the employee regions. And the employee regions, I have created the item D3D. DP3, and in the department regions interactive report, I will set two static ID. One static ID is the region static ID. Let's scroll down, and here we can see the static ID I have created, my department ID, DPP ID. And the column department number, I will create the static ID. It's department number ID. Next, I will create the two dynamic action. One dynamic action is the click the one row, and when I click the one row, I will get the department number of that row, and I will pass the department number to the page item P3 and the line DP3. And next, I will create another dynamic action, is to refresh the employee region. When the item P3 and line DP3 changed, and the employee region will refresh. And let's see. Go to this dynamic action. I will name it as get department number. And pay attention here. Event, I will select the click, and I use the jQuery selector. jQuery selector, the script is my department ID. Is the static ID of the department, and the report is actually the table in HTML, and table equal one, because in this page I have two reports, and the first report, department report, is the table one, and table equal one, and the TR is the one row in the report equal zero. I will include the headers. Equal zero refer to the headers of the table. And the action is I will execute the JavaScript code. This is the jQuery script to get the department number of that row, and I will assign the value to the page item P3 and line DP3. Affected elements is as I will select time items, and the items is the P3 and line DP3. And this dynamic action refresh, I will name it refresh three. And when the event change items P3 and the line DP3, and then the action is region employee will refresh. Now it's done. I will let's see how to run. And when we click the one row and we get the department number is 10, and I will click the this row I will get the department number is 30. When the department number changed, the employee region will refresh. Okay, today's video is done. If you have questions, please comment below. Thank you very much. See you next video. Bye.